With this, let's go to the next one, which is T, which is time of the infants, or Dasha Antara Dasha. Now again, timing is a very important thing. Once we know all these things, Raj Yoga ide, you know, uttamavagi positional career position baratte, all these things we all know, right? We all keep looking at it in horoscope. But when does it happen? Is it going to happen after I die? Or is it going to happen, did it show before my birth? Because kelo sati extra moon jarigogidre kelo miss aagirutte. When is it going to be? The most important thing for an astrologer, in addition to what Dr. Vasan has said, the third one is the timing of events. The timing yavaglunu namge, it will always create a problem. Now, in order to do the timing of events, you need to do three things. Again, I'm simplifying this for you. If you apply these three things, by and large, you will work. We call this Chara, Sthira and Nitya. Three types of analysis. You need to do analysis based on three things. Chara, Sthira and Nitya. Chara is basically Chara, movement. Go Chara, Go Chara, transits. So look at the transits. Sthira is basically your Dasha, Dasha Bhukti Galu. So there are many Dashas that are there. Most common one that we use, everybody knows, is Vimshottari Dasha. 70% of the cases it will work. There are certain special conditional dashas, which unfortunately because of paucity of time I will not go into it. I will try to give you some very good tips in Vimshottari Dasha. That is Sthira. Third one is Nitya. Nitya, the type is basically, that is, this is where you use the annual charts, Varshapala. So these three if you use, by and large you will be able to conclusively arrive at a timing. Now what I will do is, I will give you how to analyze the Dasha and Antara Dasha. Now there broadly there are two types of Dashas that we have. We have what is known as Rashi Dashas and we have what is known as Graha Dashas. So Vimshottari Dasha that you see is known as a Graha Dasha. So now if you look at how it is actually said, Sun Dasha, Venus Bhukti, atwa Moon Dasha, Ketu Bhukti, itra health artivi. Everything is a function of Grahas. Whereas if you look at certain other Dashas like Sthira Dasha, amale Chara Dasha, Ken Ravadu, Yurdala Nodre, adrala zodiac sign use martare. So you will say Taurus Dasa, Aries Bhukti and so on. So broadly you can classify them as Graha Dashas and Rashi Dashas. There are certain other types of Dashas which basically are a function of Nakshatras. But they invariably roll up to either Rashi Dasha or Graha Dasha depending on the principle that we look at. Now let's look at Vimshottari Dasha. I will give you 3 points on how you can understand the Vimshottari Dasha. The first one is, any Dasha, udaharanake let's take Venus Dasha, right? Now Venus is the planet there. Any Dasha gives its the effects of its natural tendencies depending on the Drekanna that it occupies. What does it mean? Let us take Venus is at 12 degrees. Which Drekanna is it occupying?
Second.
Now let's look at Venus Dasha itself. How long is Venus Dasha?
20 years.
20 years, right? Now let's divide Venus Dasha into 3 parts. So roughly 6 years, 8 months, roughly. Right? 6 years, 8 months. Fair enough? Now if Venus is in 12 degrees, he is in which Drekanna?
Second
Drekanna. That means during the Venus Dasha in 20 years, the second part of it, which is basically 6.6 years to 13.2 years, is where the natural tendency of Venus, the effect of that natural tendency will be given. Good or bad? Good or bad you will find out by the horoscope, the ZAP principle that I have told you. What result also I have given you in that ZAP thing. Okay? Good or bad? The next dash, next part, one third part we have found out natural tendency. The next part will be based on the house that the planet owns. So Venus is the owner of 7th house or 10th house or 12th house or whatever house it is, or some, it will be usually 2 houses, right? That effect will be given in the next part. So now right now we said Venus is 12 degrees. So second part of it is basically, it will give you natural tendencies. Venus as a Karaka, Venus as a planet, whatever natural tendency it has, it gives you effects there. The second part of it, which is now in this case third part, will be based on the house it owns. And the third part of it will be based on the house it occupies. You understood? Natural tendency, house it owns, house it occupies, in that cycle. Very clear. Now, if the same Venus is retrograde, if a planet is retrograde, whatever I have told you will go in a reverse direction. This is the trouble part of it. So, in solpa artha maadkoli. Let's assume same Venus is say in 22 degrees. If it is direct, which drekana it is? Third drekana. That basically means it has to be in the third part. If it is in retrograde motion, it will go reverse. That means it will not be in the third part, it will be in the first part. And the cycle follows. The next will be the houses it owns. After that, the houses it occupies. In that fashion. Excellent question, sir. I was actually waiting for someone. Now I know that somebody is attentive here. Because you're all so quiet, I sometimes feel whether you are enjoying whatever I'm saying or you're not enjoying whatever I'm saying. Are you enjoying?
Yes.
Is it informative?
Yes.
Okay. So good, good question. So if it is in the second retrograde, it will continue to be the second. But the cycle will go in reverse. So the house it owns will be the first part. And then the third part comes, which is basically the house it occupies. Only the middle part will be the same, but the remaining two will get swapped. Because it's in the reverse direction. Now, Rahu and Ketu? Okay, people are listening. Always retro. So that basically means you have to always look at it in the reverse direction. So for Rahu and Ketu, even though astrologically in the software sector we don't write it as retrograde, by default they're always retrograde. So always look at it in the reverse direction. Okay? Make sense so far? So Rahu Dasha, again, let's assume that is Rahu Dasha is there. What else is there? Okay, before I take that, I'll give you one more example. Let's assume Rahu Dasha is there. Rahu Dasha, how many years is it? 18 years. So split it into three parts.
6 years.
Let's assume Rahu is in, say, 23 degrees or 28 degrees. Third Drekana. So where will it give its influence? In the first Dasha. Because it's reverse. So it will give its effect in the first Dasha. So what type of results will you get during the first Dasha? Rahu, what does it mean?
Rahu is a malefic planet. But in some cases, Rahu will also become yogi. And at that time, he will give a good result.
Natural tendencies. What is natural tendency of Rahu?
He is a malefic planet. He is a mischief.
Rahu is a planet. The easiest way to remember Rahu. Easiest way to remember Rahu. Is Rahu basically means going beyond the border. Border, boundary, going beyond the border is Rahu. So foreigner, right? Out of the box thinking, Rahu. So Rahu, now we always think about it in a negative manner. So I don't like to use the word malefic and benefic because it's an English language and it's corrupted language. We've never used such words in Vedas, if you actually look. We always call it auspicious and inauspicious. And that happens primarily because, not because the planet is auspicious. It is because it is not aligned with our desires. I'll give you one example to understand this concept. Let us assume that I'm a very poor, hungry person. I have not eaten for five days. I don't have any money with me. And I am walking towards a place in a road which is completely filthy, dirty road I am walking. And suddenly I see one nice jackfruit tree with a very ripe jackfruit there. I am like, wow. And I cannot climb it because I am drained of energy. And let's assume the fine gentleman here, he suddenly comes with a Benz car, Mercedes Benz car. Full stylish. I am a person who is poor guy who doesn't have any money to eat. For 5 days I have not eaten, and our friend comes with a Benz car and he comes very fast, he splashes, and then he parks just below the jackfruit tree. Now suddenly what happens is the jackfruit, it drops, it falls, and it falls on the Mercedes Benz, and it opens up. Now this jackfruit that came, is it good, the falling of the jackfruit, is it good or is it bad? Why is it good? Good for me, bad for him. So actually speaking, it's neither good or not. It's just an event. It doesn't have a good or a bad. Now is it aligning with my desires? Yes. So that's why it is good for me. Is it aligning with his desires?
No.
That's why it's bad for him. So inauspicious or auspicious, basically it's an alignment of desires. It's not anything else. Let me give you one more simple example. There's a waterfall there. We have all gone to Joke Falls. Now Joke Falls is very pretty. You should go there. There are three things you can do. One is go like me, stand outside, enjoy the Joke Falls. Right? Second thing is a stupid guy who will go below the Joke Fall full stylish and then he'll go wash away and he'll die. Third person, intelligent person, he'll put a reactor and he'll generate electricity out of it. Now waterfall, is it good or bad? It is just a normal thing. It is neither good nor bad. But how is it aligning with my desire? Will tell you whether it is auspicious or inauspicious. Similarly, Rahu is neither good or bad. It's how you make use of this to your advantage. Do you want to make it good? Do you want to make it bad? Similarly, all the planets, you want to look at whether it is auspicious or inauspicious. If it is inauspicious, how do you convert it into auspicious? That should be your style of working with astrology. Now, Rahu actually means outside. So natural tendencies basically means that this is an opportunity where he can think outside the box. This is an opportunity where he can look at leadership capabilities. He can look at, you know, becoming a senior person. Rahu andre head, so thinking ability, right? Ketu andre body. So this is the work that people do, but this is the thinking ability that we do. So whenever Rahu is there, if you try to focus on outside the box, if you try to move out of your comfort zone is also a boundary. But if you break that comfort zone and go outside the box, everything will start working to your advantage. Because that's the natural tendency of Rahu. Use the natural tendency and you will start benefiting from it. Similarly, if you go to the... how many degrees did we say Rahu was? 23 degrees, right? So, okay, it's first Drekana. So, second part of Rahu Dasha, which result will it be? It should be reverse, remember. How's it? Occupies, correct. So second part of it would be based on the house it occupies. And the third part of it would be based on the house it owns. Perfect. How can you? Oh, good question. Very good question. Okay, now you are listening. Which house does Rahu own? So, there are two things. One is lot of hearsay that you have, but there is also what Parashara, by and large, I have seen Parashara has written about all these things. And if we don't understand Parashara, we can go into the modern scholars like Mantreshwara, Varahamira, Vaidyanatha Dikshita, even Nalla Heladre. ಇದು ಶನಿವದ್ ರಾಹು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ರೀಸನ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಶನಿವದ್ ರಾಜು ಅಂಡ್ ಕುಜವದ್ ಕೇತು ನೌ ರಾಹು ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕೋ ಓನ್ಸ್ ಅಕ್ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಸಾರಿ ಕುಂಭ ಅಕ್ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಕುಂಭ ಕೇತು ಕೋ ಓನ್ಸ್ ವೃಶ್ಚಿಕ ಸ್ಕಾರ್ಪಿಯೋ ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಓನರ್ಶಿಪ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋ